Hi students, how are you? I hope all are fine. Grade 6, Science, Chapter 6, Health and Hygiene. In this lesson, we are going to learn different components of foods and balanced diet and deficiency diseases and personal hygiene. Let's see. So, Chapter 6, Health and Hygiene. First, health is wealth. Okay, the word health means complete emotional and physical well-being. So, the World Health Organization defined health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being. So, physical avum mental avum irukkangala da nam enna solla mudiyum na healthy person appdi nam solla mudiyum. So, hygiene means cleanliness. So, brushing your teeth regularly is an important part of good oral hygiene. And then hygiene is the practice of keeping your yourself and your surroundings clean, especially in order to prevent the illness or the spread of disease. Okay, here shall we discuss the components of food. So, components of food, first one is there are six components of food. The food gives us energy, help to build our body and protect us from the diseases called nutrients. So, we need nutrients in our daily life. So, carbohydrate, fat, minerals, protein, vitamins and water. These are all components of food. These are all nutrients. Okay. The first one is carbohydrate. The carbohydrates are energy giving food. Okay, then we can obtain carbohydrates in the form of sugar, starch and dietary fibers also. So, in sugar, the form of carbohydrate in sugar, example for the sources, fruits, honey, sugarcane, beetroot. These are all the carbohydrate form of sugar. Okay, next one, starch, rice, maize and potato. These are all the starch form of carbohydrate. And dietary fibers are whole grains and nuts. These are all the carbohydrate. The carbohydrates are energy giving components of the food. Next one is, so one activity 3 is given in your book. So already I told you the starch and sugar and dietary fibers are the form of carbohydrate. So, the test presence of carbohydrate as starch in the given food item. So, what do we need means the boiled potato and a dropper and a dilute iodine solutions. You have to boil the potato and smash the boiled potato and add 2 or 3 drops of dilute iodine solution on the potato. Now, you observe, what do you observe? The potato turns blue-black in color. So, what do you infer the experiment? The iodine reacts with the starch to form a starch-iodine complex. So, this is in blue-black in color. So, the appearance of blue-black color confirms the presence of starch in the food item. Okay, this is the one type of carbohydrate. Next one is fat. The fat also the energy giving food and give the more energy than carbohydrate. Okay, compared to the carbohydrate, the fats are giving more energies. Some important fat sources are butter, ghee, milk, cheese, paneer, nuts, meat, fish, egg yolk. These are all the fat food. These fat foods are giving energies. Apart from the energy giving, they insulate our body and protect the cells. The fats are not only for giving the energy and insulate the body. Namakku eppadi irukum appadina insulate pannirukku nama body and protect the cells also. Okay, these are all called fat. Okay, next one, the activity 1-4 is given in your book. This is the test for presence of fat. You take coconut oil and a groundnut oil and any paper. Now you pour few drops of oil on the paper and rub it gently with your finger. In case of groundnut, and crush the groundnut and place it on the paper. Now you rub the groundnut on the paper. groundnut on the paper. Now what do you see? The papers turns translucent. Translucent in the pagarkata and the pakana makateria mari and the end up at a paper epidina translucent a teria kudya darko greasy arko. So the food the given food is a sample of contained fats. The food la factor kandipichikla oil food up dinger than a manala kandipichika mudio. Next one is protein. Proteins So proteins also the bodybuilding foods. So first one is carbohydrate. Carbohydrate are energy giving food. Next one is fat. Fat compared to the carbohydrate, the fats are giving more energy. And then protein. Next one is protein. Protein giving the growth necessary for our growth and repair the cells also. Bodybuilding food that is protein. Okay, and it regulates the body functions and digestion also. Some sources of proteins are proteins in pulses, eggs, fish, milk, chicken, and soya beans, nuts, gram. These are all the protein containing food. These are all the body building food also. Proteins are body building foods. The sprouted pulses pictures are given in your book, and boiled white egg also, and soya beans. These are all the rich source of protein. Okay, so compared to the sprouted pulses and boiled egg white, the soya beans is the highly rich source of protein. Okay. The activity 5 is given in your book. The test of presence of protein in the given food item. So you take egg white or copper sulfate solution and sodium hydroxide solution and a test tube and Bunsen burner. Now you take a small amount of egg white and put into the test tube and add some water and shake it. Now you heat the test tube 1 minute. After the test tube has cooled down, then you add the 2 drops of copper sulfate solution and sodium hydroxide solutions. What do you observe? The food sample turned purple or purple color or violet color. So what do you learn from this experiment? A change in the color of the food item sample turns the purple and white. So confirm the presence of protein. This is the test for protein. Okay, the food sample containing the protein. Okay, next one is, next nutrients is vitamin. So vitamins also giving the energies and it carry out the biochemical reactions in our body, and fruits, vegetables, grains, meat, these are all the good source of vitamin. These are all called, the vitamins are called protective foods. The proteins are called body building food. Vitamins are called protective foods. There are 6 major vitamins are there. Vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. Vitamins B and C are water soluble. Some of the vitamin is soluble in water and some of the vitamins are soluble in fat. There are 2 types of vitamins. So the major 6 vitamins are A, B, C, D, E, K. And vitamin B and C are water soluble. Vitamin A, D, E and K are fat soluble vitamins. Next one is in our book, deficiency diseases for vitamin. Okay. So, vitamin and found abundantly in sources and diseases we get if the deficiency in this, and then symptoms also given in the table column. Vitamin A, B, C, D, E, K. So, you have to, the deficiency diseases are vitamin A, night blindness and B are beriberi. Vitamin C deficiency, scurvy, and vitamin D diseases, rickets, vitamin E, nervous weakness and vision deterioration, and vitamin K, weakness of the bone and teeth. So these are all the deficiency diseases of vitamin A to K. So you have to just read this and the sources of vitamin in the food and the symptoms also. Okay, children. Next one is sun, and then sunscreen lotion. We are using the sunscreen lotion, you know, it reduces your skin's ability. Okay, don't use sunscreen lotion over because our skins are producing the vitamin D by the sunlight. If you we are using the lotion, it reduces your skin ability to produce the vitamin D. So okay, up to 95%. So it leads the vitamin D deficiency. Okay, so avoid the sunscreen lotions. The sunlights are good for our health, and the skin are naturally produce the vitamin D. So vitamin D deficiency, it causes the rickets. So the weakness of bone, flexible bones, and the weakness of the bones also. You have to take fish oil and milk and eggs also. It also produce our skin using the sunlight. Okay, next, and gooseberry. The gooseberry is the very, very rich source of vitamin C. Compared to the orange, it have 20 times vitamin C than orange. Okay, gooseberries are okay. So you daily take one gooseberry daily. Okay, and the next one is minerals. So minerals also the required for the growth and regulate the regulation of the normal body functions. Green leafy vegetables and spinach, pulses, eggs, milk, fish, fruits. These are all the sources of minerals in our diet. Okay, these are the minerals also the productive food. Vitamins are vitamins and minerals are productive food. Proteins are body building food, and carbohydrate and fats are energy giving food. Okay, don't forget children. Okay, next, minerals, calcium, phosphorus and iodine. The functions are the calcium, strong bones and teeth, and clotting of blood, and phosphorus, strong bones and teeth, and iodine's functions, synthesis of thyroid hormone, and iron function is formation of hemoglobin and brain development. Okay, so the minerals also very, very important for our health. These are all also the productive foods. 80% of the world production of Moringa means the drumstick leaves. Murunga kirain children, other than array vitamin C, vitamin A. Moringa leaves rich in vitamin A, C, potassium, calcium, iron, and protein. It contains the powerful antioxidants also. Okay, they take daily Moringa leaves soup. So it contains the more vitamins and minerals. Okay, and the powerful antioxidants also. Daily you take over 150 ml the Moringa leaf juice. Okay, children, and water. Water also adequate supply of the water in to maintain the good health, and any human being should take minimum 8 tumblers, 2 liters of water every day. ரொம்ப ரொம்ப முக்கியமானது. ஒரு நாளைக்கு நம்ம என்ன பண்ணோம்னா 8 tumblers of water வந்து கண்டிப்பா குடிச்சே ஆகணும். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் பேலன்ஸ்டு டயட். வாட் இஸ் பேலன்ஸ்டு டயட்? Amount of all the necessary nutrients required for our health and activity. So contains the sufficient amount of various nutrients to ensure our health. So the ஒவ்வொரு எனர்ஜிஸும் ஒவ்வொரு மினரல்ஸும் நம்ம எவ்வளோ பர்சன்டேஜில் இருக்கணும்னு சொல்கிறதுக்கு பேர் தான் பேலன்ஸ்டு டயட்ஸ். So sufficient amount of various nutrient to ensure our good health, that is called balanced diet. So the food also providing the appropriate amount of energy and adequate amount of water. Okay, next. So the balanced diet increases the capacity to do work and good physical and mental health, increase the capacity to resist the disease also, and proper growth of the body. Next one is small nutrients. So when you see the diet is not balanced, what will be the consequence? So above the picture, so pictures are given in your book, children's pictures, you just look this. So what would be the reason for this? Children are looking here like, so this is called malnutrition. So malnutrition means the nutrients occurs when all the nutrients that the body needs are not obtained in the proper proportions. In the proper proportion is from the diet. The diet na enadhu ella ப்ரிப்போசிஷன்ஸும் கரெக்டாக இருந்ததுன்னா, நியூட்ரிஷன்ஸ் ப்ரிப்போசிஷன்ஸ் கரெக்டாக இருந்ததுன்னா அது பேரு பேலன்ஸ்டு டயட்னு சொல்கிறோம். அது நமக்கு கிடைக்காம இருந்ததுன்னா வரதான் என்ன சொல்கிறோம்னா மால் நியூட்ரிஷன்ஸ் சொல்கிறோம். மால் நியூட்ரிஷன்ஸ் அப்படின்னா த பர்சன் டஸ் நாட் டேக் ஏ பேலன்ஸ்டு டயட். ஸோ இட் லீட்ஸ் த டிஃபிஷியன்சி டிசீசஸ், தட் இஸ் கால்டு டிஃபிஷியன்சி டிசீசஸ், லேக் ஆஃப் நியூட்ரிஷன்ஸ் இன் த டயட், தட் இஸ் கால்டு டிஃபிஷியன்சி டிசீசஸ். In India, the second highest number of obese children in the world after the China. Okay, maximum 14.4 million children in the country have excess weight. And you see this picture, Kavaskar and marasmus deficiency, protein deficiency, children picture are given in our book. So the protein and mineral deficiency symptoms are Kavaskar, stunted growth and swelling of face, limbs and diarrhea. And marasmus causes kidney appearance and slow body growth. And minerals, enna minerals nala enna deficiency varudna, calcium deficiency causes the rickets, phosphorus deficiency causes them osteomalacia, and iodine causes the goiter, and iron causes the anemic persons also. Okay, so we take the all the nutrition in the proper preparation, that is called balanced diet. Okay, if you not take the proper nutrition, you will you are attacked by the diseases. So okay, the protein diseases like Kavaskar and marasmus, etc. Okay, you take the proper propositions of nutrition in the diet. So it is very important one. Okay. So not only balanced diet, we need physical exercise and rest also very important for the human body. The physical activity means playing games, sports, yoga and exercise, dance, active living. So these are all the physical activities we need. So if you doing the body activity enhances the increase the growth and development and strengthening the muscles and cardiovascular systems also. And the physical exercise help to decrease the some of the effects of childhood and adult obesity also reduces. And rest, the proper amount of rest is essential for the physical and mental health. So it is also the very important as nutrient and physical activity of the growth and development of the good health. So early to bed and early to rise make a man healthy, wealthy and wise. This is the proverb of Benjamin. He said that Benjamin Franklin. So you have to keep in your mind and do exercise and take the proper rest, essential rest also, and proper cleanliness. Cleanliness means hygiene. So the World Health Organization already told you know hygiene refers the conditions of the practices and help to maintain the health and prevent the spreading the diseases. So individual care of one's body health and well-being through the cleanliness, the proper personal habits like bath, washing hands, trim the fingernails and changing clothes, these are all the hygiene process. Okay, next one is, so if you not follow the hygiene, we will attack by some microbes. So some personal hygiene and frequency of cleanliness chart is given in your book, high hygiene. So commonly eye hygiene daily, every morning and whenever the face is dirty. So next second one is hair hygiene, weekly twice or once a very very other days. Eppra pannu hair vandu wash pannirukku, weekly twice adu hair wash pannirnu. Body hygiene abingiradhu one or twice a week. Oral hygiene ingiradhu brushing twice a day or rinse after the each meal. Ovvoru thara saapidanum vaai kuplikiradhu romba nalladhu. And feet hygiene ingiradhu every day. Hand hygiene every time after touching the contaminated surfaces. Contaminated edavadhu polluted ah irukkakudiya surfaces neenga thottinga, every time before eating and touching the clean surfaces you have to wash your hand. And clothes hygiene ingiradhu once or twice a day vandu nama enna pannanum, dress vandu potta aluk dress nama poda koodadhu. Next, introduction of microbes. When you neglect the personal hygiene, you will affect by the diseases. Some microbes cause the diseases for you. So so next, the some microbial diseases are caused by some microbes, that is bacteria, virus, protozoa and fungi. It causes the diarrhea, tooth decay and anklet foot, adhaadu madurai foots nu solvanga, and dandruff. These are all the causes of microbes. Okay, we cannot see the microbes in our naked eyes. So it is, these are all very tiny particles. Okay, we cannot see without the, we can see only the help of microbes only, microscope only. Okay, the some microbes are bacteria, virus, and protozoan and fungi. So bacteria is a very small prokaryotic microorganism. Prokaryotic means do not have the nucleus in the cell. Okay, they do not usually have the membrane and the cell சுத்தி என்ன இருக்கும் அப்படினா உள்ள வந்து நியூக்ளியஸ் இல்லாம இருக்கிறது தான் ப்ரோகாரியோடிக் செல்னு சொல்றோம். இது ப்ரொவைட்ஸ் இட் ப்ரொடியூசஸ் த பஸ் அண்ட் ஹார்ம்ஃபுல் வேஸ்ட் ஆல்சோ. த பாக்டீரியல் டிசீசஸ் ஆர் காலரா டிரான்ஸ்மிஷன் பை த கண்டாமினேட்டட் வாட்டர். நிமோனியா இஸ் இன்ஹேலிங் த இன்ஹேலேஷன் ஆஃப் ஏர்போன் டிசீசஸ். ட்ராப்லெட் அண்டு தும்பும் போது இருமும் போது நமக்கு இந்த பாக்டீரியா டிசீசஸ் வந்து வருது, அதுதான் நிமோனியான்னு சொல்கிறோம். டெட்டனஸ்ங்கிறது வூண்டடு வித் த கண்டாமினேட்டட் ஆஃப் வூண்டட் வித் த பாக்டீரியா. டியூபர் க்ளோசிஸ் அப்படிங்கிறது அதுவும் ஏர்போன் ட்ராப்லெட்ஸ்னால நமக்கு வரக்கூடியது. அடுத்து டைஃபாய்டு கண்டாமினேட்னா ஃபுட் அண்ட் வாட்டர். தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் த பாக்டீரியா டிசீசஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட்டு virus. Virus, see this picture. This is the structure of virus. This is the infect agent, typically in the nucleic acid molecule in the protein coat. Okay, virus can infect the all type of life forms, plants, animals and microorganism also. It is a living normal cells, and they use the cell machinery to multiply. Okay, and they can kill the damage and change the cells, make you sick. Okay, this is caused by virus. Some diseases are caused by virus. One is common cold, influenza, hepatitis, polio, smallpox, chicken pox, measles. These are all the virus deficiency, virus diseases. Okay children. So virus also the microbes, that is also the one microbes. We cannot see our naked eyes. The virus that contains the RNA instead of DNA is called the retrovirus. Okay, the diseases of the definite pathological process having the characteristic set of signs and symptoms, that is called diseases. Disorder means derangements or abnormality of the function, that is called disorder. Okay, disease and disorder. Okay, what we have to learn from this lesson, there are the six nutrients: carbohydrate, fat, protein, vitamin, minerals and water. Carbohydrate and fats are energy giving food, proteins are body building food, vitamin, mineral, these are all the water, these are all the productive food. Okay, water is the நம்ம என்ன பண்ணோம், 2 liters of water நம்ம டெய்லி எடுத்துக்கணும். ஓகே, அண்டு சம் ப்ரோட்டீன் டிஃபிஷியன்சி டிசீசஸ் வில் காஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த deficiency of protein, kawaiskar and marasmus, and some vitamin deficiency diseases also, night blindness, scurvy, rickets and beriberi, and some microbes also we have to see in this, learned from this lesson. Bacteria, that is a prokaryotic microorganism, and bacterial diseases, cholera, typhoid, pneumonia are caused by the bacteria, and some viral diseases, influenza, common cold, chicken pox, these are the viral diseases. Okay children, so health is wealth, so be hygiene. Okay, take care of your health, eat the diet food, the proper prepositions of nutrients. Food is called diet, balanced diet food. Okay, you take the balanced diet food and be healthy. Okay, take care children, thank you.
In this lesson, we learn the different components of food and balanced diet, deficiency diseases, personal hygiene, and this is caused by bacteria and virus. Okay children,